Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, you'll learn about the relationships that exist between angles and sides in a triangle. It looks like Mia got a little head start on this topic without us, so we better get caught up. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to compare angles and sides within a triangle to draw conclusions about their measures and lengths. First, we'll learn about the relationship that exists between a triangle's angles and sides. Then, we'll complete a practice problem together. I got a question for you. If I give you this triangle and these side lengths, can you instinctively place them on the correct sides of the triangle? Give it a try. Where do you think these side lengths should be placed? Did you place them here? If so, what was your reasoning? Did you go by how the side lengths looked compared to each other? Or did you use the angle measures to help you in some way? What if it's harder to tell which side length looks shorter and which one looks longer, like in this triangle? Or what if the triangle just isn't drawn to scale? Can you place the side lengths in the correct locations now? Here's their correct placement. It was probably a little harder to tell where to place them compared to the previous triangle. Let me fill you in on a little secret. The shortest side of the triangle will always be opposite to its smallest angle. So find the smallest angle in each of these triangles. Is the shortest side in the triangle directly across from them? Yes. 15 degrees is the smallest angle in the first triangle, and 3.6 is the shortest side in the first triangle, and they're opposite to each other. And in the second triangle, 50 degrees is the smallest angle, and it's opposite to 6.5, which is the shortest side of this triangle. Take a moment to pause the video here and convince yourself that this is true in both of our triangles. If you're not convinced, try drawing a triangle where the smallest angle isn't across from the shortest side. The same is true for the largest angle and the longest side. The largest angle in the first triangle is opposite to the longest side. And the same is true with the second triangle. Also, we can go in both directions. So if I give you the longest side, you would know that it's across from the biggest angle. And if I give you the biggest angle, you would be able to say it is across from the longest side. We're going to do one example problem next, so pause the video here if you need any time to catch up in your notes template. This problem says to write an inequality to describe the sides of the triangle based on their lengths from least to greatest. Now remember that the triangles you see will not always be drawn to scale, so we need to make sure that we're applying the relationship that we just learned to solve this. What side do you think is the shortest side? Here's the smallest angle, so the shortest side will be directly across from it. Since we're supposed to order the sides from least to greatest, let's write this side first. Going in order, our next smallest angle is 60 degrees, and the side opposite to it is side DE. So we can write that next in our inequality. Then finally, the largest angle of 62 degrees is across from side EF. So we can write that in the inequality too. And that's our answer. Also, as a hint to help you on your practice problems, pay close attention to what the problem is asking you to do. You may also be asked to write the inequality from greatest to least. Paying attention to the little details like that is a super important skill, so make sure you practice your attention to detail in the practice game for this lesson. Now you can compare angles and sides within a triangle to draw conclusions about their measures and lengths. It's time to finish your notes template. There are a few more problems for you to try and check with an adult before starting on your practice game. See you next time! Hey!